first and 10, wants it all. Deep over the middle for Winicky, has it inside the 10.
Still with it, Diana Powerhouse!
Ilfil Velez on the run, diving in the alley.
It's Alexander with a nice move, goes to the rim, got it to go!
The Jackrabbit Insider is on the air. Hi, friends. Tyler Merriam, and welcome inside the Yeager Media Center. We have an interesting show this week with a pair of senior student-athlete spotlights. We'll go up into the air with one soccer player and through the legs of football long snapper Thayer Trenhill. The SDSU golf team opened up play today in its Jackrabbit Invitational, the event it hosts down in Valentine, Nebraska. We'll talk to Coach Casey Van Dam, and we'll be joined by SDSU football coach John Stiglmeyer. But we begin with a young lady who started out as a nursing major, and now she's majoring in aviation. Let's go up into the air with soccer's Maddie Yule.
It's a funny story. So I originally came for pre-med and quickly switched to pre-nursing went to do that. And I followed my aunt around and I loved what she was doing because she's a nurse back in Minnesota. And I was at one of my mom's friend's birthday parties when I was back home for winter break my sophomore year. And I met one of my mom's friends that she plays mom soccer with, who is a pilot for Delta and does international travel kind of stuff. And she was telling me about her lifestyle and what she does, and I love to travel, and everything made sense. And so
the following semester, Yule needed to find a one credit course to meet her student athlete eligibility requirements when she just so happened to come across an aviation discovery course. Little did she know that one credit would change her career path.
When I got here to take that discovery flight when I was thinking about switching my major, they were like, you're gonna take off and you're gonna fly the plane. And I was thinking I was gonna sit in the back and just kind of look around and ride in a plane for my first time. And when I went up, it was oh my gosh, like I'm in the plane, I'm doing this by myself. And it's, you can kind of relate it to when you can drive a car for the first time, except you can kind of go up or down or anywhere. And it's pretty cool. It's kind of a breathtaking thing. And it's kind of fun to be like, yeah, I get to go to the airport for my class and fly an airplane instead of being like, well, I have this chem lab that I need to finish or kind of thing. And it's just a totally different experience, and it's great to be up in the air and see Brookings from a different perspective.
So she juggles life on the turf and in the air, a move that she says not everyone was on board with at first, including her coach.
First, I know Lang was kind of worried, and so were some of my academic and athletic advisors, for making sure that I was eligible, along with being able to graduate in soccer and stuff like that, because you have to have a certain percent of your major done by each year to be eligible. So it was very interesting to try to navigate that, and once we figured out it would work, I did a lot of classes last year to make sure it could work. I did 15 in the fall, 15 credits in the fall, and 18 in the spring to be able to kind of jam that all in to make sure that I was eligible for soccer. And now it's just making sure that I'm communicating early enough about my schedules and trying to balance that. I mean, I've been balancing soccer and school and other activities my whole life, and so it's been easy to, I already understand how it works, and so I was able to adapt pretty quickly, but it's definitely been a little difficult to try to manage both of them at the same time.
The senior midfielder has been an integral part of the Jackrabbit soccer team's offense this season, scoring set-piece goals in back-to-back games versus Northern Iowa and Kansas. She says success on the field and in the air are very similar.
My style of playing soccer is a lot of organization on the field. Like, I really like to organize and communicate. And that's, I mean, you have to think ahead of the play also in soccer. And so you have to know what you're going to do next. And with flying, you always have to stay ahead of the plane and know what you're going to do next, kind of predict what's going to happen next and know what the next thing that needs to happen and stay ahead of it. So you can be proactive to things, and it helps knowing what I need to do and like in soccer, and that relates over to flying as well.
She's traveled all across the country for soccer, including back-to-back trips to the NCAA tournament. And while her soccer career will come to an end, her traveling days won't. Yule has aspirations to visit destinations she never once thought possible.
I would love to be able to fly overseas, over the ocean, and fly to different countries all over the world and get to kind of get paid to travel. I mean, obviously there's a huge responsibility of flying huge planes like that, but I think I'm totally up for it, and I would love to spend that time and be able to get paid to travel to China or Africa or some crazy place like that. It would be great.
Madison Yule and the Jackrabbit soccer team open up Summit League play next week. The SDSU football team has this weekend off, but we'll catch up with the head coach of the Jacks. John Stiglmeyer joins us after we take you inside state.
There's something in Hobo Week for everybody. I competed in Cavorts, the talent show. It was just something we were going to do for fun, and we ended up winning, so that was really sweet. My name is Hope Yager, and I'm from Watertown, South Dakota. SDSU is cool because it's so community-based. Even though there's 12,000-plus students, I can always walk through the union and know someone. I think it's really cool, all the different types of friends you get to meet. We do homework together. We sing together a lot. We just do random things. We go to Qdoba. We go there probably 3 times a week. That's accurate. I go there a lot. On Halloween, we actually have this thing called Rocktoberfest, and it's where we all like dress up, and we had like a dance party and stuff, and it's just really fun. My major here is music education, and I specialize in vocal. I want to be maybe an elementary choir director. I like kids a lot, and high school students too, but kids are kind of more geared towards me, I think. I'm really involved with Oasis through the Wesleyan Church here. Also, I'm in concert choir, so that's pretty much like a sport, and that's where I met like most of my friends. I've met a lot of people that are kind of nervous to come to this university just because it's so big and like they don't know how they're gonna fit in, but I would really just give the advice to try everything and anything. Thanks to SDSU, I'm ready to make what I love doing into a career.
And Ryan Berry takes the snap, looks out, here comes the blitz. They try to pick it up, they do, they throw it, got Manette out of the backfield, inside the 20, to the 10, to the 5, touchdown! Kyle Manette!
Listen up, this is the time, this is the place, and this is Ford F-150, the truck that goes toe-to-toe with your life. Made of high-strength, military-grade aluminum alloy, it pulled the highest safety rating the government can give. And with Pro Trailer Backup Assist, it's like having your head on a swivel, pal. So load up your crew. This is the time.
Now get up to $10,395 in total savings or lease an F-150 for just $279 a month. Visit your local Northland Ford dealer today.
How did we become the region's largest independent seed company? By taking a very simple but powerful stand. We will sell no seed that we wouldn't be happy to plant on our own farm. Peterson Farm Seed. Stand tall.
Being part of a great team means you know your role and you work your role to the best of your ability. If you're consistently going to show up and be your best, you're going to be part of that team. You can see the success they have over time. It's not just 1 year flash in the pan. It's consistent success over time, which makes them great. And that's where the work ethic comes in. The ability to come into work, do the same thing repeatedly, day after day after day, and putting your best foot forward is going to separate you from the rest.
Choose the experts. Choose Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine.
This portion of the Jackrabbit Insider is brought to you by Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. Expert care when you need it.
Welcome back. No game last night for the SDSU football team. The Jacks open Missouri Valley Football Conference play hosting Western Illinois on Saturday. So what did they do on this idle week? Let's find out with head coach John Stiglmeyer.
The bye week is to get healthy. The bye week is to address some things that you're not as good as you want to be. We're following a game that really doesn't apply to anything, so we're going to address not only some of the scheme things, but more importantly, just the execution of any technique you need to do. And that's accountability. That's belief. That's focus.
One area that the Jacks have not lacked focus in is the special teams. Brady Mengarelli ranks in the top 25 nationally in kickoff returns. SDSU has blocked 2 punts and missed only 1 field goal and no PATs through the first 3 games.
I'm really happy with our special teams. We have 2 new special teams co-coordinators, and I think they've done a great job of raising our level and addressing things every week. I thought the greatest improvement was our kickoff team this week that was really dominant. And we did some good things return-wise. We did some good things in the other phases.
On offense, quarterback Taryn Christian has not 1 but 2 All-America candidates as receivers. Junior wideout Jake Winicky has already earned All-America accolades each of the last 2 seasons, and he's caught 20 passes for 329 yards and 8 touchdowns, ranking in the top 10 nationally in each statistic. Meanwhile, tight end Dallas Goedert has matched him with one highlight reel catch after another. He's made 14 receptions for 249 yards and three scores.
Jake and Dallas are really special players, and you still have to defend Marquise, you still have to defend Connor, you still have to defend Taron running the ball and our running backs, but those two guys are go-to guys and have the ability to make the big play.
Stig would like to see some improvements in the run game. SDSU is averaging 129 yards on the ground. That's next to last in the Valley.
I think we do some good things. You know, we need to stay on blocks better. We need to know our rules better. You know, there's some things that Polly did that caught us off guard, and it took us a while to get caught up. And when we get all that stuff down, again, three new guys in offense, that takes a while.
The defense is also a point of concern. Opponents are averaging 524 yards and 41 points through three games.
Well, we surely have to play better run defense. And we're giving up way too many yards per carry. And part of that was the offense we just faced. But we weren't great in the other two games either. And so we're going to address that. And I promise you, the Jacks will be a much better team defensively next week.
Now, at least some of the defense's struggles can be attributed to injuries. Senior safety Nick Mears was injured on the first series at TCU and has not played since, although he is expected back this week. Defensive tackle Shane Gutlob returned against Cal Poly after missing the first two games. But starting defensive end Jared Bloom was sidelined last week. The hope is everyone will play on Saturday.
You lose a starter, our belief is the next guy up's great. But the guy, on the other hand, the guy's a starter for a reason. You know, Nick Mears, Jared Bloom, Shane Gutlob, those guys are really good players. But I'm going to continue to believe in who's ever on the field. I'm going to rejoice when we get those starters back.
This Saturday marks the Missouri Valley Football Conference opener against a much-improved Western Illinois team, which is saying something since they were in the playoffs last year and changed head coaches.
Western Illinois is, I think, I've earned voting for that guy for a coach of the year. You know, I've watched their film, and they're doing a phenomenal job with the change of schemes. I'm looking forward to studying their program even more. But they're a really good football team. They're going to win a lot of games.
The Jackson Leathernecks will play at 6 p.m. Saturday at Dana J. Dykal Stadium on Military Appreciation Night. It's a special occasion for the squad.
We love military appreciation, and especially nowadays where there's so much turmoil and hate in the world, so many crazy things going on. I think it's really special that we just pause one game and honor those individuals. And hopefully even police departments feel honored this evening.
Fans can purchase tickets to Saturday's event by calling 1-866-GO-JACKS or visiting jackrabbittickets.com. The first two home games saw terrific crowds, and Stig is hoping for more of the same on Saturday.
I'm really happy with how our fans have gotten involved in the games and trying to affect the game, both cheering us on and being abusive to the opponent. And the more we can do that, the better off this environment gets.
1-866-GO-JACKS or jackrabbittickets.com to join us as SDSU hosts Western Illinois on Military Appreciation Night, Saturday at 6 p.m. inside Dana J. Dykal Stadium. A senior student-athlete spotlight on long snapper Thayer Trenhill after we relive this classic SDSU football game from 8 years ago.
The fifth meeting for the Dakota Marker featured a career-defining drive for Ryan Berry. It's this week's Jackrabbit Legend, presented by Legend Seeds. The Jacks ventured into the Fargo Dome, where better than 18,000 fans witnessed a classic. SDSU dominated early, but had to settle for three field goals and led just 9-7 at halftime. Starting quarterback Ryan Berry left the game with an injury. Backup Ryan Crawford took over. His screen pass to Kyle Manette handed the Jacks a 17-14 third-quarter lead. But NDSU regained the advantage, and with just over 6 minutes left, the Jacks found themselves behind 24-17. Crawford had gone down with a hand injury, and Berry was called back into service. He engineered an 8-play, 68-yard march, capped by a touchdown toss to Jerron Harris. Rather than go for a tie, Coach Stig went for two, and Berry hit Mike Steffen for the game-winning 2-point conversion. SDSU won the Dakota Marker for the second straight year. A 25-24 victory in Fargo over NDSU November 22, 2008. A Jackrabbit Legend. This Jackrabbit Legend is presented by Legend Seeds, your regional seed leader.
Being part of a great team means you know your role and you work your role to the best of your ability. If you're consistently going to show up and be your best, you're going to be part of that team. You can see the success they have over time. It's not just 1 year flash in the pan. It's consistent success over time, which makes them great. And that's where the work ethic comes in. The ability to come into work, do the same thing repeatedly, day after day after day, and putting your best foot forward is going to separate you from the rest.
Choose the experts. Choose Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine.
Get ready for the Hefties Fan PhD Tip of the Week, encouraging you to get up, get loud, and get involved, and give the Jackrabbits a hometown advantage.
This year was fantastic. I got my best yields ever.
Record yields start by putting the best seed in the ground. At Hefty, we not only pick the best genetics and traits for you, but we have the most stringent seed grower specs in the industry. That means higher yields for you.
We're Hefties!
And we're big on the farm.
Hefty brand soybeans. Agronomy, answers, yield.
Hey, Jacks fans. We love to have you at the game. We love your involvement. Again, make sure you're positive. Not everybody at the game is an SDSU alum, and so this is our chance to sell who we are and what we're about, so be positive.
This week's fan tip was brought to you by Hefty's Fan PhD, helping Jackrabbit fans go from good to great.
The Jackrabbit Insider continues. An SDSU football fan from as far back as he can remember has been the starting long snapper for the Jackrabbit football team for the last 3.5 years. Our senior student athlete spotlight shines on Thayer Trenhill.
I'm one of the few guys on the team that could probably say that they remember when there was no Dyke House, and it was just pine trees out to Highway 14. And so that's super cool to say and to be a part of my last year opening the stadium.
He is truly the picture of a young man living out his dream. He pursued it. He worked tremendously hard in high school. At his stature, he was not going to play football at this level unless he did something like long snapping, and he worked hard on it, and now, after having been a Jackrabbit fan, now he's living his dream.
Although Trenhill didn't grow up dreaming of being a long snapper, he actually took up the position almost by accident.
So I started long snapping in seventh grade. My middle school team only had 11 guys, so you couldn't really choose what position you wanted to play.
He perfected the craft thanks in large part to the coaching he received at the Coles kicking, punting, and snapping camps that are held throughout the nation.
I went there the summer after my freshman year, and it just sort of snowballed because they said I had a lot of potential to go far in it. That made me really want to work hard at it and keep getting better every day and just to see where it could take me.
You know, and most of these guys have been non-scholarship guys that we've recruited to try to pursue their dream. We did the same with Thayer, and Thayer's story is kind of unique because he got called into service a little early, but he's been tremendous for our football team.
Trenhill graduated from Sioux Valley High School and was planning on redshirting his freshman season. He worked that summer at the university bookstore and would come watch practice before going home each night.
And literally he was watching practice one day when our starting snapper was injured and couldn't snap anymore. And so that night he gets a call from Shannon Moore and says, "You're in fall camp," and from then on he's been our starting snapper.
Trenhill has been the starting long snapper for 3+ seasons, handling all of the duties on punts, field goals, and extra points. And there's a lot more to the task than people probably realize.
Punt snaps, it is a full body experience. Almost like an explosion. You stretch out a rubber band and all of a sudden it goes. I'm involving my feet, arms, core, legs, everything about it. Core is extremely important in the long snapping world. It keeps you balanced, and you have a lot of power and strength in there that you got to use if you're blocking guys. And then field goals, you're just trying to keep your base stuck, your feet stuck in the turf or grass, what we've had for the past 3 years. And that's more of an upper body snap.
Trenhill is loved by his teammates, as evidenced by one of the most anticipated parts of every Thursday among the squad, the weekly Thayer Trenhill joke.
Ethan Sawyer, the punter, then threw me in there to start telling jokes. And so I started doing research on the internet. I started on Tuesdays, Wednesday nights.
They're terrible jokes, but they look forward to him telling the joke.
I was scared going into those first couple jokes. Those were really rough.
The jokes and the presentation are bad. His timing is a little off, but it's tradition.
delivery has definitely gotten better over the years. I still get nervous for it.
He's just a positive guy. He's not a big guy, but he does his job all the time, and guys respect that.
Trent Hill will graduate in May with a degree in hospitality management alongside minors in management and events and facility administration. But he'll worry about everything else after his senior season at State.
Really open about anything at this point. Enjoying every second I got with the guys, for sure. And then we can focus on whatever's next after the season.
Thayer and the SDSU football team host Western Illinois Saturday night at 6 o'clock at Dana J. Dykal Stadium. Time for this week's Jackrabbit Hot Seat.
Hi, I'm Mackenzie Wolf. I'm from Rapid City, South Dakota. I am an interior design major and a minor in marketing, and I'm on the women's soccer team. My favorite TV show is Grey's Anatomy. It's always super intense and makes me excited to get to the next show. My favorite food is probably pizza. I feel like you can never go wrong with that. My pregame ritual is probably dancing in the locker room with all my teammates and just jamming to songs. My favorite subject is probably math. I like solving problems, and I like how there's a definite answer at the end. The best part of Brookings is Zesto's and Nick's Hamburgers. I love going to those places, and it's only in Brookings that you can get them. I chose SDSU because meeting the team, I loved the family atmosphere it had, and it's still close enough to home where my parents and other family members can come and support me at my games.
An update on the Jackrabbit golf program is coming up, but first we go back to the right arm of Todd McDonald and his aerial show from 24 years ago.
Farmers are paying more attention to water quality and making it a priority.
Every farm is different, and every farmer is different. But everyone wants to do what's right for the environment. We're conserving the water, the limited water that we do get, and we're not wasting it.
The individual farmer has to be proactive.
No-till allows our crops to use all the water that we are blessed to receive.
We keep water clean.
For the people of South Dakota, it's about doing the right thing.
I am Al Miron.
Steve Halverson.
Jeff Lockner.
This is Farming.
Listen up. This is the time, this is the place, and this is Ford F-150, the truck that goes toe-to-toe with your life. Made of high-strength, military-grade aluminum alloy, it pulled the highest safety rating the government can give. And with Pro Trailer Backup Assist, it's like having your head on a swivel, pal. So load up your crew. This is the time.
Now get up to $10,395 in total savings or lease an F-150 for just $279 a month. Visit your local Northland Ford dealer today.
The Jackrabbit Insider is brought to you by the Hefty Seed Company, Agronomy, Answers, Yield. Your local Northland Ford dealers. Visit northlandford.com or your local dealer. Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. Expert care when you need it. The University Bookstore. Shop now at jackrabbitcentral.com. South Dakota Corn. This is Farming. Proud sponsor of the South Dakota Showdown Series. And by South Dakota State University. Be great. Start here.
Thanks for joining us this week on The Insider. The SDSU men's golf team hosting the Jackrabbit Invite down in Valentine, Nebraska. First of 3 days of competition today. While the SDSU women are also off to a very successful season. So for more on both of those squads, we talked to the director of golf, Casey Van Dam.
fall's gone very well for the women in particular. We've won our first two tournaments of the year, which we're really excited about, and we've got a great team looking forward to the rest of the fall.
As Van Dam mentioned, the women already have two tournament titles under their belt, winning the Omaha Invitational by 25 strokes to open the month, and then erasing a 10-stroke deficit in the final round en route to a title at Missouri State last week. And it's been a true team effort, with Haley Goetz, a senior from Pier, turning in a pair of top five finishes. On the men's side, Grant Smith's 12th place finish at the Wisconsin Badger Invitational has been the highlight so far, but the men will face their steepest challenge yet this weekend. In only its second year, it's already known simply as the Jackrabbit, a premier event that Van Dam has pushed for since he was hired as the director of golf.
It opens up so many doors for our program to get invited to other tournaments, and so the Jackrabbit started with just an introduction to the owners of the Prairie Club, and then telling them my vision, and then it kind of went from there. We had a great first year.
Let's begin with the venue. The Prairie Club is located in Valentine, Nebraska, about a 4.5-hour drive from the SDSU campus. The Dunes course was co-designed by 1996 PGA Tour Player of the Year Tom Lehman and was voted the best public golf course in Nebraska.
Awesome venue, really very, very difficult. 8,000 yards, it can be played up to 8,000 yards, and the teams rave about it. It's in the sandhills of Nebraska, very different topography. Very different than most college events, and it kind of sets us apart that way.
And based on the teams involved in this year's Jackrabbit, the tournament will indeed be premier.
The University of Tennessee, Clemson, which has been a top 10 program for a long time, a lot of tour players from Clemson. Oregon State is coming this year. Of course, we have Nebraska and Creighton, a little local teams, and then we'll have Central Florida, Connecticut. We've got teams from all over, Missouri, an SEC school as well. So we're really excited. We've got a strong field.
The teams involved make the tournament a big one, but another layer to it is the College Am event that took place Saturday. Fans had the opportunity to play the challenging course alongside some of the nation's top men's golfers.
We've got a lot of SDSU supporters coming this year. We've got about 45 people that have signed up with the package to come play in the College Am, and they're going to get to see up close and personal what a college tournament's like and actually participate in the College Am with the college players.
But you don't become a successful golf program without having support from top to bottom. That includes caddies. Enter the Fluff Cowan of the SDSU golf program.
This is awesome.
We need a deal so we can take down our yardage.
Yardage rock?
Director of Athletics Justin Sell caddied for the women at practice this week.
Justin is a big supporter of golf. He loves golf. He happened to be out here today I did his podcast with him, and so he really enjoyed being out here with the ladies and helping him out a little bit.
The many talents of Director of Athletics Justin Sell. This Saturday night, the SDSU football team hosts Western Illinois. It's Military Appreciation Night. We hope to see you out at Dana J. Dykal Stadium. Highlights of that game, thoughts from Coach Stig, and much more next week. So for all of us here inside our Yeager Media Center studios, I'm Tyler Merriam, and we'll see you next time on the Jackrabbit Insider.